Dear students, welcome to another class of respiratory system. In this class, we are going to discuss about exchange of gases. So, exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide. So, where the exchange of gases takes place, the primary site for exchange of gases is the alveoli. So, alveoli are the sac-like structures which are present in the lung region. And the second site for the exchange of gases is between the blood and the tissue. So primarily the exchange of gases is taken by a process which is known as a diffusion. Diffusion is a process in which the gases moves from higher concentrations to lower concentration of the respective gas. So what is meant by partial pressure? So partial pressure is the pressure exerted by the individual gas in a mixture of gases is known as partial pressure of that gas. So if you want to know the partial pressure of oxygen, so it is the partial pressure of oxygen is nothing but the pressure exerted by the oxygen molecules in the gases. So the atmosphere here contains a different gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, helium, all these gases are present in the atmosphere. Okay. Among those mixture of gases, the only the oxygen molecules which exert the pressure in this mixture is known as a partial pressure of oxygen. Likewise, pressure of the air, that is 760 mm of mercury. It is denoted by Hg. Mercury is denoted by Hg. That's why we write that partial pressure as a P. P means partial. The next is the respective gas. So PO2 means partial pressure of oxygen. PCO2 means partial pressure of carbon dioxide. And the units for partial pressure are mm, Hg. Mm means millimeters of mercury. So mercury is denoted by symbol Hg. So next, the factors which influence the diffusion. So the first and more foremost factor which influences the diffusion of these respiratory gases is the partial pressure of gases or the concentration gradient. The second one is solubility of the gases. And third, thickness of the respiratory membrane. So now fourth one, surface area, and the fifth and the last one is distance of diffusion. So we will discuss each and every factor in detail now. So first one, the partial pressure of gases. So partial pressure of gases means O2, and we are interested only in oxygen and carbon dioxide and not all the other gases present in the air. That's why whenever I say gases, that means the structure of alveoli. So this is the structure of alveolus. So alveolus is a sac-like structure which consists of a single membrane of a squamous epithelial cells, and each alveolus is surrounded by a capillaries, blood capillaries. So this is the blood capillary. So each blood capillary consists of endothelium. This is the endothelium of capillaries, and this is the squamous epithelium of the alveolus. The space between the alveolar wall and the blood capillary, that is endothelium. So this region is known as basement substance. So this region is known as a respiratory membrane or diffusion membrane. So through this membrane only carbon dioxide and oxygen are diffused into blood or out of blood. So this region, they come to the atmospheric pressure. We know that atmospheric pressure is of air is 760 mm of Hg. In that 760 mm of Hg, partial pressure of oxygen is 159 mm of Hg, and partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 0.3 mm Hg. So you have to remember the partial pressures of oxygen and carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. In the alveolar air, so when the air enters into the alveoli, so as the air enters into the alveoli, in the alveolar cavity, the pressures of oxygen and carbon dioxide are like this. Partial pressure of oxygen in the alveolar cavity is 104 mmHg and partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 40 mmHg. So there is a vast difference between the partial pressure of oxygen in the alveolar cavity and in the atmosphere. In the atmosphere it is 159 mmHg and in the alveolar it is 104 mmHg. So we all know that gases move from higher partial pressure to lower partial pressure, and that is known as diffusion. So that's why the oxygen from the atmosphere enters into the alveolar cavity. Simultaneously, the carbon dioxide with the high partial pressure in the alveolar cavity, that is 40 mmHg, in the atmosphere it is only 0.3 mmHg. That's why carbon dioxide goes outside of the alveolar cavity. And from this alveolar cavity, the oxygen has to diffuse into the blood. So first it has to diffuse into the blood of the capillaries which surrounds the alveolus. So here the partial pressure, of oxygen is only 95 mmHg when compared to the partial pressure of alveolar air, that is 104 mmHg. Here in the capillaries, the partial pressure of oxygen is only 95 mmHg, that is oxygenated blood. That if there is a difference between the partial pressure of oxygen in the alveolar cavity and in the blood, oxygen moves from higher partial pressure to lower partial pressure. 95 mmHg is less than 104, so the oxygen easily diffuses from alveoli into blood. Oxygen comes inside the blood. From here, this oxygen has to be transported to the tissues through the systemic arteries. So this oxygen goes to the heart, left part of the heart. From the left part of the heart, it enters into the systemic artery. From systemic artery, it is distributed in each and every cell of the body. We consider this as a systemic arteries. So oxygenated blood with partial pressure 95 mmHg moves in through the systemic arteries and enters the tissue. So this is tissue. So this is the tissue. In the tissue, cells are present. So cells use oxygen, and so they used oxygen, so the oxygen concentration is very less in the cells. In the cells, the partial pressure of oxygen is only 40 mmHg. So there is a difference. That is, here 95 mmHg in oxygenated blood, and here in a tissue cells, the partial pressure of oxygen is only 40 mmHg. So there is a difference in the, so from higher partial pressure to lower partial pressure, so the oxygen diffuses from systemic arteries into the tissues or the cells. In tissues, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 45 mmHg. In the oxygenated blood, the partial pressure of carbon dioxide is 40 mmHg. So there is a difference in the partial pressures of carbon dioxide also. So that's why the carbon dioxide from the tissues with the high partial pressure moves into the blood. Oxygen moves from blood to the tissues, and carbon dioxide from the cells moves to the blood. So then this blood becomes deoxygenated blood. As the oxygen is liberated in the tissues, and the amount of oxygen is reduced in the blood, and the amount of carbon dioxide is increased in the blood, then the blood is known as deoxygenated blood. In the deoxygenated blood, the partial pressures of oxygen and carbon dioxide are like this. Oxygen is 40 mmHg and carbon dioxide is 45 mmHg. So this is the deoxygenated blood. So deoxygenated blood is carried in the veins of our body. And these veins, systemic veins, carry the deoxygenated blood to the heart, right part of the heart. And from there, through the pulmonary artery, it reaches the lung region. So it reaches the lung, deoxygenated blood reaches the lung region. So in the lung region, the capillaries, blood capillaries, the blood flows as the partial pressure of deoxygenated blood is 45 mmHg, and partial pressure in the alveolus is 40 mmHg. So the carbon dioxide from blood, deoxygenated blood, is enters into the alveolar cavity. So from there, it goes outside of the body. It enters into the atmosphere. At tissue levels, carbon dioxide is more and oxygen is less. Why this situation occurs? Because the cells use oxygen for respiration. That's why, so this part here, it is known as internal respiration or systemic respiration. So the exchange of gases, the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide at tissue level is known as internal respiration or systemic respiration. So the exchange of oxygen and carbon dioxide at alveolar level is known as pulmonary respiration or external respiration. So next factor that affects the diffusion is the solubility of gases. So here, carbon dioxide is more soluble. It is 20 to 25 times more soluble than the oxygen. That's why carbon dioxide is easily diffused from blood into the alveolar sac. As though the partial pressure is less, but the solubility of carbon dioxide is more. That's why it easily diffuses from blood into the alveoli and it is removed from there. Okay, so that is the solubility of the gases. Next, thickness of respiratory membrane. We all know that this is the respiratory membrane. So the respiratory membrane consists of three layers. That is the squamous epithelial layer of the alveolus, next endothelium of the blood capillary, and the gap between these two layers is the basement substance. So these are the three layers of the respiratory membrane. And because these three layers are very thin, they are made up of only a single cell. So that's why the respiratory membrane is very thin and it helps in the exchange of gases through this thin membrane. Next, surface area. Surface area is very large. In the lungs, alveoli, sac-like alveoli, number of sac-like alveoli are present, and each alveolus is surrounded by a bunch of capillaries. So this wall of the alveoli, so this wall, as there are numerous alveoli in the lung, so all the walls of the alveoli together constitute the surface area for the exchange of gases. Carbon dioxide is more. If the surface area is less, exchange of gases will be less. That's why numerous alveoli present in the lung region. And you have to remember the different values of partial pressure of oxygen and the carbon dioxide. So only you have to remember three. That is, atmospheric partial pressure of oxygen is 159, at the alveolar region 104, alveolar region 104, at the oxygenated blood it is 95 mmHg, and in tissues and deoxygenated blood it is 40 mmHg, and for carbon dioxide atmosphere is 0.3 mmHg, in the alveoli it is 40 mmHg, in the oxygenated blood also it is 40 mmHg, and in the tissues and deoxygenated blood partial pressure of carbon dioxide is slightly increased, that is 45 mmHg. So this is about the exchange of respiratory gases. In the next class we will study about the transport of gases. Okay, until then keep studying.